Hi everybody, it's Natasha and welcome back to my closet. So I'm making a highly requested video today. For years people have been asking me to make a video addressing body shaping, and they asked me to talk a bit about how I achieve my figure, and I finally decided to make a video. I usually just tell people check my playlists because you'll figure out all the secrets there, and I would advise you guys to do that because I've set up a few different playlists in my playlist section on my channel. Basically, you'll see a whole section there on body shaping and padding, and so that's really important. You can check out that. I mean, what's important is to educate yourself about, you know, different options that you might have. So you can check my playlist, you can check other videos on YouTube, but there's definitely a lot of information there about padding and corsets and things of that nature. So step one, look into my playlist and you'll get some insights right away. But I'll address a few different things today, actually. And so I want to talk about the first thing that helped me a lot. And obviously, if you've been watching my channel for years or for a little while, you've probably noticed an evolution in my body. Anyways, I notice it. But I've been, you know, working out. That's one of the main things that has helped me evolve with my shape over the years. So I do exercises, a lot of exercises. And again, in my playlist section on my channel, you'll see a whole section devoted to hip and butt exercises. So that's what I do. I do a lot of hip and butt exercises, and as well as leg exercises. So for the quads, you can do squats, you can do a bunch of hip exercises that are laid out in some of those videos that I have on my channel in the playlist section. There's a few different target exercises that you can do to help you, you know, gain wider hips, larger butt, you know, quads. All those type of things will help. And if you can go to a gym and use machines, wonderful, do that. I don't actually go to a gym. I'm not subscribed to any gyms, so I just do a lot of this stuff at home. I have some leg weights and other types of weights, free weights that I use, and there's a lot of stuff you can do just with the simple body weight, you know, things that are very simple to achieve. So first thing, exercise. And with the exercise, I would also add diet. Because diet is super important, guys. You guys gotta eat properly, eat well. You know, I can't stress enough, you have to be healthy and have a healthy and a low weight midsection. So this is important because a lot of times when we're eating unhealthy, what happens is that it creates a lot of belly fat, and you know, you have that tire around your belly. And when you're trying to achieve a feminine figure, you're looking to go for like an hourglass figure, which means, you know, wide, come in for the hips and then come out, come in for the midsection and come out for the hips. So if you have like this tire around your midsection, it's not going to help with the hourglass shape. So you really have to consider what you're eating, and obviously eating foods that are low in fat, cholesterol obviously too, but low in fat is important, and you know, eat healthy. Diet and exercise is crucial. That's one thing that really helped me. So I'm kind of naturally slim, so I kind of have an easier time with that. But you know, depending on your body shape and body size, some people are a little bit more rounder, some people are skinnier, slimmer, some people are mid. You know, so you have to look into that and try to figure out what works for you. So diet and exercise, tip number one. Tip number two, this is where the cinchers and all that stuff comes in. Okay, so you can use waist cinchers, you can use body shapers, these one-piece body shape things that you can buy that actually help to suck in fat a little bit here and there. There's hip pads, there's butt pads, there's padded panties. There's all sorts of different things, and people ask me, so like, what's your secret? It's because I'm always using different things. So in addition to the body shape that I'm gaining through exercise and stuff, I use different padding for different outfits. So it depends. Obviously, if I want to show my midsection, I'm not going to use a waist cincher. So it's important to use something else, you know, that's going to maybe give you wider hips. So you have to sort of look in the mirror and see what tool is going to work best with that particular outfit. So I will show you some of the tools that I have that I've been using over the years, and we'll start with the waist cincher. So I had bought this on Amazon like a long time ago. And at the time, I think I only paid $15 or $10 for something like that. It was ridiculously cheap. But anyways, see, it's got these clips and hooks, and you have three different sizes. So you're gonna actually, have it a little tighter. You can have it a little bit looser, or you can sort of have it in the middle. And these really work well for giving you that hourglass figure. So this will squeeze in that midsection. So. That's super important if you can get yourself a waist cincher, and it will help with a lot of different outfits. Like I said, some one-piece things that you can buy also in lingerie sections of certain things. Like I have this one too that you see, it's like it just slims everything out. It's a one-piece thing, you know, it's got like hooks for the crotch and everything. And but that works really well, and it also serves as a bustier, so it helps to, you know, bring in your bust a bit. I have different colors, so this one is like more of a beige color thing, and again, it helps to squeeze in certain sections. So you can use the cinchers, or you can use these type of things. I have many more of these, but I'm not going to bring them all out at this point. So yeah, those are two things. Now another thing you can use is padded panties. So here is one of the ones that I use. So again, I got this off Amazon. It's like a padded panty, and if you notice in the back, the buttocks are accentuated. So from the side, you see you can get on, and this works great for summer outfits and things like that. And I've even doubled up on these, so I have a few pair of these that I can, you know, sometimes put one on top of another and get like a wider shape if I want, depending on the outfit again. Sometimes you don't need a lot because a dress is already cut in a flare shape, so it's like the flare shape on its own will give you like that feminine figure. You don't necessarily need tons of padding at that point. Sometimes you do. If you're wearing a tighter dress or whatever, then you probably want to, you know, work with your padding a little bit more. So that's another thing, padded panties. And then there's these. These are normal hip pads that go down the leg a little bit more. So they're a little bit longer, these hip pads, and they're in that Africa shape that is so important. And they go on the side of your hips. And I'm sure you've seen these before. And again, if you haven't, check out my playlist. There's a lot of people talking about these. So I bought these off Amazon, and I got a good deal. I was actually looking for silicone pads, and it said silicone, so I ordered the silicone, and they sent me this. And I wrote them back, and I said, that's not what I ordered. And they said, oh, sorry, it was sort of mentioned that they were foam. And I said, no, I clicked on the silicone thing. Anyways, they gave me a rebate, and I decided to keep them. And they work pretty well. You do need, you have to wear either a lot of pantyhose with them or dance tights, and to get rid of the edges. So again, if you're wearing tighter dresses, you'll see the ridges if you don't wear like something tight like dance skins or stuff like that. Now, the thing about these is that you can make your own. So if you watch my section again in the playlists, they'll show you how to actually make them on your own. You can use like foam cushions that you can buy like at Walmart, or you can actually just take an old cushion that you have at home or something like that and cut them out of there. And that works pretty well. And the advantage about that is that it's custom made, you know? So it's really, you're measuring your hip line, you're measuring the length down to your knees, and depending on if you want them longer or shorter or whatever, you can really make your own. And I've made some over the years and with some pretty good results. So there was a lot of hit and miss with that. Sometimes they didn't come out very well. But you know, you can actually get something that works for you if you try it out. So have fun with that. That can also work. Another thing I have, another tool I have is this. These are like, they're like shorts, but they're padded shorts. So there's padded panties and then there's padded shorts. So these ones are a little bit longer. They're almost like bicycle shorts. And then there's padding in them. So, and there's actually pockets, so you can add your own padding, or you can use, you know, you can make them bigger, wider, smaller. So I found these on Amazon again, and I don't actually know if the company still exists. It felt, when I ordered it, it felt like it was like some drag artist or something that was like selling these and making these online, and actually pretty well made, and they've lasted me a long time. So I use that a lot with, like, for example, summer dresses, where, you know, you can't be in summertime, it's so hot, you can't be wearing like a bunch of padding and like tights and everything. You'll be sweating, you'll be melting, it's crazy. So something like this is really comfortable, and it's, you know, helps to keep your legs cooler, and you can wear a dress, a longer dress or a shorter skirt or whatever, and they work pretty well. So those are some of the tools that I use. So that's my second tip, is obviously get some good body shaping tools for yourself, and that will really, you know, help you achieve your figure. Last thing I want to talk about is posture. So the third thing is posture. And a posture is so important, guys. You guys need to have a good posture. So let me just, you know, give you an example. For example, if you're standing or you're trying to achieve a figure and you're standing with your shoulders out like this, that's not going to give you a feminine shape. So you have to have your shoulders back, up, back, you know, head straight. Keep your shoulders back, rolled back a little bit. So basically, just roll them back. You know, picture there's like a pool noodle between your shoulder blades, and you're squeezing that pool noodle together. And that'll also help to give you a slimmer upper shape. And, you know, another thing you could do if you're taking pictures is to, you know, swing your hips out a bit to one side, you know, holding your arms in like that, things like that. So if you're standing around, don't always just stand straight, right? You can stand, lean out a bit, swing the hips out a little bit. So all those things are super important for shape, and it's subtle stuff, but it's important stuff, and that's really gonna help you as well. So those are the three things I could say: diet and exercise, first thing. The second thing, get yourself some good body shaping tools, padding, whatever works for you. There's a lot of different tools out there that you can work with. And then the other thing would be, you know, consider your posture, because bad posture will give you a funky shape. Thank you, guys. I'm going to stop at that. With that for today. So I really appreciate you guys tuning in, watching the video. I hope it was informative. I hope you enjoyed it. And thank you again for subscribing and watching and commenting. I really appreciate all the lovely comments that you guys send me. And it really warms my heart to hear all that stuff and feel your support and love. You guys are awesome. Thank you once again. Have yourself a wonderful day, a wonderful week, a wonderful year, and we'll see you soon. Take care.